Now class, we will understand the answers which we have done for the given worksheet. The first sentence says, Kavita is unwell. She did not go to school today. In this sentence, Kavita is the noun and it is replaced by she in the second sentence. Okay. Now she is always a personal pronoun, but in the personal pronoun, I have told you subject pronoun or object pronoun. So we will check what type of pronoun it is. It is a subject pronoun. Now the question comes, how do we know it is a subject pronoun? The pronouns which act as the subject of the sentence or the doer of the sentence. She did not go to school today. About whom are we talking about in this sentence and who is the doer of the sentence? She. So it will come under the category of subject pronoun. Now move to the second sentence. Radhika is a good girl. Everyone likes her. Radhika is the subject in the first sentence. In the second sentence, Radhika is replaced by her. But she is not the subject. Who is the subject? Everyone likes her. So, when the pronoun receives the action done by the subject, it is called object pronoun. Okay, so we have written here object pronoun. Though you will write in these type of sentences that it is personal pronoun, but you should know what is subject pronoun and what is object pronoun. Now the third sentence, we bought two hats. Okay, the blue one is Meena's and the pink one is mine. If you notice in the chart provided to you in the previous lecture, mine is the form of possessive pronoun. How do we know it is possessive pronoun? One is the clue word and second, when it is used, we, in that we, one is Meena and another one is the speaker. Who is showing the ownership of the pink hat by saying that pink one is mine? The person is not saying it is my pink hat, okay? Because when they say my hat, it becomes possessive adjective. When there is no noun or the word mine is used, it shows it is possessive pronoun. Now moving to the third, Suresh and Reena has two cars. The Jeep is his and sedan is hers. Now in the first sentence you can see there are two nouns, Suresh and Reena, where Suresh is a masculine and Reena is feminine. And according to that, if we want to show the ownership, belongingness or possessive pronoun, we will use according to their gender. For Suresh we will use his and for Reena it is hers. Okay, that's why it is a possessive pronoun. Coming to the next sentence, who went to pick up grandpa? Now here the clue word is who. But how do we know, is it a interrogative pronoun or a relative pronoun? So if we focus at the last part of the sentence, there is a question mark. Question mark tells us ki here the who word is used as a question. And as there is no noun after this who, it is an interrogative pronoun. Now another example, whose is this car? Again, it is an interrogative pronoun because whose I have given you in the list, it's an interrogative pronoun. And the question mark makes our doubt clear whether it is a relative pronoun or an interrogative pronoun. Now coming to the next part, that is the lake where we can go rowing. Now that is the lake. Now we are focusing on that lake. So that is the demonstrative pronoun. We are not saying that lake. If we say that lake, it becomes demonstrative adjective. But we are saying that is the lake. Verb is coming after the demonstrative word. So here it is working as demonstrative pronoun.